A very warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for being with us. My name is Zunaina Latif. I work here as Director Kashmir Cell, and I'll be your host today. Every year, on the occasion of Kashmir Solidarity Day, we reaffirm our unwavering moral, political, and diplomatic support to mark our solidarity with Kashmiri people in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir. On this day, we have gathered here to pay rich tribute to Kashmiris for their resilience in their just struggle for right to self-determination. Ladies and gentlemen, a picture is worth a thousand words. Today, while we honor Kashmiris in face of Indian occupation forces, we have privilege of showcasing photography works of native and internationally acclaimed photojournalists who have captured Kashmiris' valiant struggle across globe, especially post 5th August 2019. While everyone may have his own interpretation and imagination about exhibits on display, you may observe that two things remain common in all photographs. One, agony in face of oppressor, and two, unshakable resolve and hope in eyes of Kashmiris for culmination of their just struggle. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning, we also pay tribute to rich cultural heritage with display of exhibits demonstrating Kashmiris' love for art and culture against all odds. While many of us appreciate elegant Kashmiri Pashmina shawls, it's heartening to note that Kashmiri music, cuisine, handmade carpets, embroidery, and handicrafts form significant part of Kashmiri identity. Let us start our event with the electronic recitation of verses from Holy Quran.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the especially merciful.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
All praise is due to Allah, Lord of the worlds.
Ar-Rahmanir Rahim.
The entirely merciful, the especially merciful.
Maliki Yawmiddin.
Sovereign of the Day of Recompense.
Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in.
It is you we worship and you we ask for help.
Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim.
Guide us to the straight path.
Sirata al-ladhina an'amta alayhim ghayril maghdubi alayhim waladdallin.
Of those upon whom you have bestowed favor, not of those who have evoked your anger, or of those who are astray.
A'udhu billahi.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I request? Ladies and gentlemen, may I request all of you to please stand up for National Anthem of Pakistan and Azad Jammu and Kashmir to be played on the screen.
Oh,
Mr. Sardar Masood Khan, President of Azad Jammu and Kashmir, for his remarks.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. Honorable Foreign Minister, Honorable Shibli Faraz, members of the Diplomatic Corps, ambassadors sitting here, Foreign Secretary Sohail Mahmood, and all others who are assembled here today. Assalamu alaikum, good morning to everybody. First, let me pay a tribute to the Foreign Minister and Foreign Ministry for diversifying their diplomacy. In the recent past, they have taken many initiatives to digitalize our diplomacy, and that effort is succeeding. But it's not just one field. They are, in fact, diversifying foreign ministries' outreach in various fields, and thank you so much for doing that. Thank you also for focusing on Kashmir day in and day out, whether it is your spokesman's statements, whether it is your own pronouncements, very authoritative pronouncements, or whether it is the entire machine which is working for the realization of the right to self-determination of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. And we are grateful to you. The people of Jammu and Kashmir are grateful to you for that. Let me also tell you that this exhibition that you have organized is both timely and very important, because a cultural invasion has started in the Indian-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. And the world is watching. But it is watching. UNESCO is silent, and so are other international organizations. They haven't paid attention to this parallel invasion that started on August the 5th, 2019. I can tell you that there's a planning in Delhi for constructing some 100,000 temples in the occupied territory. There are threats to mosques and shrines in the occupied territory, and all vestiges of Muslim culture and heritage are being wiped out, or there are plans to wipe them off the landscape of the Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir. So this is one thing that is happening. Other symbols have been taken away, or other cultural traits of the Kashmiris. For instance, their language, dress is also being challenged. It is being ridiculed, it's being cartooned. I'm proud that today many foreign ministry officials have donned the cultural apparel of Kashmiris. Thank you so much for doing that. Let me also tell you that, Islam came to the state of Jammu and Kashmir not by conquests, but through the teachings of mystics and saints. And that's why it was accepted by the entire population. The conversions that took place were very smooth, were very voluntarily. So there were no enforced conversions or proselytizations. Now, let me tell you that one of the figures that we always commemorate and remember is Shah Hamdan, who traveled all the way from Central Asia, and centuries ago, he brought with him arts, crafts, and industry. And that's why you see these distinct characteristics, like you have carpet weaving and shawl weaving, you see this wood carving, and most of them have come from Central Asia, which creates and reinforces this affinity between the state of Jammu and Kashmir and Central Asia, and also Pakistan. So, I think that Kashmiri culture is distinct, Kashmiri language itself, Kashmiri is also cherished, the use of English, of Urdu as lingua franca, and that also has been attacked. In fact, it has been replaced by the Hindi language and Hindi script. So this is Devanagari script, as it is called. So it is a big challenge. So when you hold an event like this here in the Foreign Ministry, it will send a message, a loud and clear message to the Indians, the genocidiers there in the Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir, to these violent extremists sitting in Delhi and executing their evil plans. It will also send a message to the international community, and there are so many representatives of the international community who are sitting here today. So thank you so much, Foreign Ministry, for doing that. And let me come to the last point. And the last point is that in Azad Kashmir, you'd be surprised to know, very many people do not know, we have rich cultural heritage also. We have ancient shrines. And we have, for instance, I mean, shrines of Saheli Sarkar or Baba Sahib Shaheed, and there are others, for instance, Khadi Sharif and Haji Peer. And you go to Azad Kashmir and you'll see shrines of saints there on the peaks. Most of these saints prefer to go to the peaks, very inaccessible peaks, but they have their shrines there. Peer Chirasi, there is another shrine. We also have these ancient buildings and structures. For instance, in Sharda, we have a 2,000-year-old temple, which was in fact a university. And we are trying to reincarnate it as a university. We also have Boxer Fort, which is about 600 years old. We have Ramkot Fort, Mangla Fort, Red Fort in Muzaffarabad. We also have another fort in Muzaffarabad. But what I want to say is that you have a very rich and diverse landscape in Azad Kashmir, and we can promote this tourism, not only religious tourism, but also we can show lots of antiquities to the people, which date back centuries, as a matter of fact. So, and we have started that process. I can assure you that the government of Azad Jammu and Kashmir has started that process. We're planning in collaboration with the government of Pakistan. I also want to thank the OIC organization. It is called IRSICA, which in early 2019 held a very successful exhibition here at Serena Hotel, which was inaugurated by the President of Pakistan. And it was organized in collaboration with the government of Pakistan and also government of Azad Jammu and Kashmir. My invitation to all of you is to come to Azad Jammu and Kashmir and to visit these places. And you'll be fascinated and mesmerized with not only the rich historical heritage that we have, but also by the warmth of the people who would receive you there. My final point is that I spoke as the president of Azad Jammu and Kashmir. The title of the state is the state of the Azad state of Jammu and Kashmir. What does that mean? When we constituted this government back in 1947, October the 24th, 1947, this government represented the entire territory of Jammu and Kashmir, and this was the liberated part. This was the liberated part. So I am the president of Azad Jammu and Kashmir, and I spoke as the president of Azad Jammu and Kashmir. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, and congratulations to the foreign minister, to the foreign ministry for this great initiative. You have touched the hearts and minds of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. Thank you.
Thank you for your valuable remarks. May I now invite on stage Sayyid Shibli Faraz, Minister of Information and Broadcasting, to offer his remarks.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Honorable Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Saab, President Azad Kashmir, Excellencies, diplomats, ladies and gentlemen. First and foremost, I highly appreciate the photographic exhibition organized by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, which among other facets of life also highlights the cultural scenic beauty of Indian IIOJK. Kashmir, no doubt, is a heaven on earth, which fortunately has been turned into hell by the cruel and inhuman treatment meted out to the Kashmiri people by the Indian security forces backed by the Indian government. During events organized over the past few days, the international community has witnessed the magnificent show of solidarity with Kashmiris by the Pakistanis at home and abroad. But let me say that expression of solidarity with the Kashmiri people is not a one-time event or activity. It has never been so. Government and people of Pakistan have extended support to the Kashmiri brethren throughout the last seven decades and would continue to do so until the Kashmiris succeed in their struggle for their inalienable right to self-determination. Pakistan, under the bold leadership of Prime Minister Imran Khan, has rejected India's illegal actions of 5th August 2019 and internationally highlighted the humanitarian, legal, and peace and security dimensions of the issue. Prime Minister Imran Khan has reached out to the world leaders, international institutions, the UN, the OIC. He has forcefully raised the Jammu and Kashmir dispute on all multilateral and international fora. Our efforts to project the Kashmir cause have not gone unnoticed. United Nations Security Council has discussed the Jammu and Kashmir dispute three times since 5th August 2019. UN Secretary General has affirmed multiple times that the position of the United Nations of Jammu and Kashmir is governed by the Charter of United Nations and applicable Security Council resolutions. World leaders, international human rights organizations, as well as the media have been at one in condemnation of the lockdown by Indian occupation forces in illegally occupied Jammu Kashmir. The struggle and expression of solidarity will go on until the purpose is served, providing Kashmiris their right to self-determination in line with United Nations Security Council resolutions. Pakistan has repeatedly expressed its desire for peace. Unfortunately, India has vitiated the atmosphere which its illegal and unilateral measures of 5th August 2019 in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir. Such a situation cannot be allowed to linger on anymore. It is time that the international community takes cognizance of the ill will of India and its evil designs to usurp the rights of Kashmiris in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir. We stand by our Kashmiri brethren in their just struggle for the right to self-determination, and each passing day, our support for the innocent Kashmiris will be further strengthened. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable remarks. May I now request Honorable Foreign Minister Makhtoom Shah Mahmood Qureshi, the chief guest, to please come up on stage to offer his keynote address. Sir.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Minister for Information, Mr. Shibli Faraz, Mr. President, Foreign Secretary, members of the Diplomatic Corps, officers of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamualaikum. I have a written text and I can read it out to you, but you know it all. It'll just be repetition of what you already know. The question today is, how do we resolve this dispute? Can we wish it away? We cannot. Is there a military solution? There isn't one. Are we talking? No, we are not. Did the actions or the measures taken on the 5th of August 2019, did they achieve what they were meant to achieve? Perhaps not. Human rights violations, are they taking place? Yes, they are. Are people suffering? Yes, they are. Has the economy of Jammu and Kashmir been affected adversely since the 5th of August 2019? Yes, it has. Where do we go from here? India has often been saying that this is an internal matter. Is it? No, it isn't. If it was an internal matter, then why were we talking about it when we had the composite dialogue and the comprehensive dialogue? Why was it on the agenda? It was on the agenda. Is it on the agenda of the Security Council? Yes, it is. Has the Security Council since the 5th of August deliberated upon it? Yes, it has. Is the world concerned when they see escalation of tensions on both sides of the line of control? The world is concerned. Yes, it is. Do you read about ceasefire violations on a daily basis? Yes, you do. The President just offered and invited you to come and visit Azad Jammu and Kashmir. Please go there. meet people, talk to them, and assess for yourself, what do the people want? Allow the Indians to let the diplomatic corps go to Jammu and Kashmir and meet people freely. And then make an independent assessment. India very successfully, in my view, after 9/11, when they saw the global environment change, they linked the struggle for self-determination to terrorism. Very smartly done. They linked it to terrorism. What I want the world to assess independently, that is the issue being orchestrated from this side of the line of control, or is it a genuine indigenous issue? We have to have clarity. Unless we get clarity, we will not reflect over the solution. Do we want to live in peace with India? Yes, we do. Do we want to have good neighborly relations with India? Yes, we do. Has South Asia suffered because of this dispute? Yes, it has. Have we invested enough in our social sectors, in health, education, drinking water, sanitation? No, we have not. Why? The question is why? We have limited resources, and they should be optimally used. How do we use them when there's tension brewing on both sides, on the eastern side, on the western side? Are we helping facilitate peace on the western side? Yes, we are. Is the world recognizing it today? Yes, it is. Pakistan has changed, and Pakistan is changing. And we are a relatively new party with a new mindset, with a new approach. In the past, we've been talking about the geostrategic location of Pakistan. Today, we want to talk about the geo-economic importance of Pakistan. Because of this dispute, is SAARC functional? It isn't. Are we trading within the region as we should? And we have seen regional trade grow everywhere. European Union is in front of you. And there are many other, ASEAN is a very good example. Can we trade? Yes, we can. But we are not. What's the bottleneck? We have to understand. And we need the support of the international community to understand. What the present regime in India has done is unsustainable. Where are the investments that were promised? Have they come in? Where is the flourishing tourism? It's destroyed. Look at the economic impact the measures of the 5th of August have had on Indian Jammu and Kashmir. Devastating. The question is, what are we doing about it? You have diplomatic relations with India. We recognize that and we respect that. As sovereign countries, you're entitled to have good bilateral relations with them. And we don't grudge that. Honestly, we don't grudge that. We want to move on. How do we move on is the question. I would want, my Prime Minister wants, Imran Khan wants, my government wants, peace, stability, development, education, health. You know, the world has suffered from COVID-19. And believe you me, we were scared when the first wave hit us. How will we cope with this challenge with the fragile healthcare system we have in place? We are fortunate, things didn't spin out of control. We've dealt with it reasonably well, but the challenge is there. Could we have cooperated within the region to overcome the challenge of COVID-19? Yes, we could have. We didn't. We did. Can we wish the challenge away? We cannot. We will have to face it. Collectively, regionally, we could have done a better job. Well, we've managed better, in my opinion, better than India. If you look at the economic contraction that we've had and the economic contraction that they've had, 10.3% decline in their growth compared to what we have sort of contracted by. So the time has come to reflect. How do we move on? What's going on is unsustainable. Jammu and Kashmir is under military siege since the last 18 months. Can it go on like this forever? Can you have a communication blockade forever? Can you overlook the two reports of the Human Rights Commissioner? You can choose not to talk about it. You can choose to look the other way. But that does not change reality. And that's where we seek your attention. We want to resolve this issue through dialogue and through peaceful means. That is preference number one, and the only sensible preference. How do we do it? Did we vitiate the climate? No, we did not. Who will create that enabling environment that is required to re-engage? That's the question. This exhibition that you're witnessing today is just an expression of what's going on. The picture is far worse than what is being reflected here. So please, write to your capitals, inform them about what the real situation is. I expect the new Biden administration that has always spoken about fundamental human rights to stop ignoring the ground realities over there. I expect the OIC that we are founding members of to not overlook the sentiments of people in their countries. Priorities of governments can be different, but the sentiment of the people is somewhat different. Recognize it. See for yourself how things are moving. I expect the European Union, one of our largest trading partners, to play its role. I'm grateful to the European Parliament for having discussed this issue, the issue of human rights. We are thankful to members of the British Parliament and the all parties parliamentary group on Kashmir, the House of Commons, for contributing and highlighting the misery, the brutality that is taking place. We all have to sit and find a way out. I'm not saying we have all the solutions, but this cannot go on like this. This cannot go on like this. Something can go wrong, even accidentally. Those who are shy of getting involved will willy-nilly get involved. Because when peace and security is affected, then you will be sucked in. So, reflect about it and play your role. You will find Pakistan engaging, reasonable, and willing to look at things objectively. Thank you for showing solidarity, and thank you for your presence. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, Jan Morris rightly says, Kashmir has always been more than a mere place. It has quality of an experience or state of mind, or perhaps an ideal. May I now request Foreign Secretary, Mr. Suhail Mahmood, to please come up on the stage to present special Kashmir solidarity souvenir by Foreign Office to the guest speakers. May I invite Sardar Masood Khan, President of Azad Jammu and Kashmir, on stage to receive the souvenir.
Aspects of the Kashmir dispute. I'm making a suggestion. Since you have so successfully organized this exhibition, the next exhibition should be on photographic compilation of the genocide that is going on in Kashmir and this illegal importation of population, because plenty of footage is available which has been put on the net or which has been exhibited elsewhere in India
and that needs to be archived and that needs to be displayed. We see genocide as it is happening. Thank you so much.
May I now invite Foreign Minister Makhdoom Shah Mahmood Qureshi on stage to receive the souvenir. May I request the Foreign Minister to present the Kashmir Solidarity Souvenir to the Foreign Secretary. May I now invite Dean of the Diplomatic Corps to come up on the stage to receive the souvenir. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, poetry and music are integral part of distinct Kashmiri culture. In this backdrop, in collaboration with Youth Parliament, Foreign Office is inaugurating a Kashmiri cultural song titled Nigaro, sung by a Kashmiri, Zohaib Zaman, who is a member of Youth Parliament. Nigaro is a visual representation of pure Kashmiri culture and hope by depicting story of love between divided families across LOC. The song presents message of hope that one day Kashmiris' dreams will come true to be united with their loved ones. For them, the day is not far. With this, let's watch the song.
Thank you. तक सजाएं बटेंगी उदासी की रातें कभी तो कटेंगी सिखाया है उसने कि लड़ना है कैसे बचाते हुए उसने मरना है कैसे उसे जन्नतों की हवाएं मिलेंगी उदासी की रातें कभी तो ढलेंगी उदासी की रातें कभी तो कटेंगी
Ladies and gentlemen, as this event is a collective effort of Kashmir Cell, I must acknowledge teamwork and contribution of all member institutions constituting Kashmir Cell, as well as Ministry of Kashmir Affairs and Gilgit Baltistan, Kashmir Liberation Cell, and Cultural Academy of AJK Government, Youth Parliament, and Islamabad Administration in supporting this event today. Ladies and gentlemen, poet Agha Shahid Ali said these lines for Kashmiris, and I quote, "We shall meet again in Srinagar, by the gates of the Villa of Peace, our hands blossoming into fists till the soldiers return the keys and disappear. Again, we will enter our last world, the first that vanished." Let's have a big round of applause for Kashmiris. May I now request the Honorable Foreign Minister to inaugurate moving photography and cultural exhibition and take a picture with 3D photo booth which depicts Lal Chowk Clock Tower in Srinagar. The square is witness to Kashmiris' struggle for their right to self-determination for 7 decades. Ladies and gentlemen, you are also requested to proceed to enjoy the exhibits along with delicious Kashmiri cuisine. Thanks a lot for being with us. Have a great afternoon.